Okay. Welcome back. Correct Danish sentence 3, and this means that I'm going to give you a lot of sentences, and you have to guess which one is the correct one. It's pretty simple. So I would say this video is sort of like maybe lower intermediate. If you're very basic, this is not for you. But let's begin. Let's begin this awesome video. Alright, so the first one, you see here, there's the meaning in English, so you know what it's supposed to mean. It's not your business, like, it's not your business, eh? Like, it doesn't concern them. Let's see. Det er ikke din forretning. Det er ikke din ting. Det kommer ikke dig ved. Det er ikke dit. Alright, let's look again. Det er ikke din forretning. Det er ikke din ting. Det kommer ikke dig ved. Det er ikke dit. Alright, take a second. Think about it. Yeah. Which one is correct? Which one is it? Alright, let's find out. Det kommer ikke dig ved. Yep, the third one. Det kommer ikke dig ved. Now here's the logic. Forretning, yes, forretning is business. Like you got a business going, you're selling stuff. Or the actual store, and kind of like boutique. But that's of course the literal business, not like, you know, someone's business, like their affairs or what's going on. It's different. Det er ikke din ting. That's, we just don't say that. I mean, you could if it's like a physical object, but we're not talking about that. Det kommer ikke dig ved is sort of like, it doesn't concern you. Like, come is come, and ved is like at, to approach, or to be at a spot. So it doesn't reach out or enter your territory, or whatever you want to say. So det kommer ikke dig ved. I could also say, det rager ikke dig. That's a little more harsh. That's almost like, it's none of your damn business. Eh? It's a little more harsh, but yeah, this is a good one. Det kommer ikke dig ved. Or det kommer ikke whoever it is. Eh? Doesn't have to be dig. Could also be ham or hende or the person's name. It's really simple. Det ikke dit is of course wrong, because it's like, what? What does that mean? It's not yours. Like, what thing is not yours? So, that's all it is. And coolio. Alright, the next one is, what will you do about it? What will you do about it? Hvad vil du gøre om det? Hvad vil du gøre ved det? Hvad du vil gøre med det? Hvad vil du gøre omkring det? Alright, it's interesting. Still once more. Hvad vil du gøre om det? Hvad vil du gøre ved det? Hvad du vil gøre med det? Hvad vil du gøre omkring det? Okay, take a second. Think about it. Which one is correct? Yeah. Alright, I'll give it to you. Let's see. Hvad vil du gøre ved det? Yep, the second one. Hvad vil du gøre ved det? Let's go through them. Hvad vil du gøre om det? We don't say that. That is not a thing. Now, I know that this might be tempting to think because of about. Now, you're used to about meaning om, like vi snakker om, we're talking about, something like that. But this is different because it's like to impact or influence the situation, and then we say vil, right? That is why we say gør ved det and not om det or any other preposition. Right? The third one, hvad du vil gøre med det. You can see here from the order is that hvad du, that's of course a statement. Right? You gotta have the verb before the subject, or you got a statement. So hvad vil du? And gøre med, yeah, you could say that, like if you have something, like a tool or something, eh? Like how will you use it? But that's different. I've heard some people say this before, because med is similar to ved, but it's still not the right one. Alright? So vidde is the right one. And hvad vil du gøre omkring det, the last one? Omkring means like around, rather than about. Right? Sort of like jeg går omkring, ikke? Walk around. Or her omkring, here around. Around here. Right? But it's different. It's not the right answer here. Yeah. Alright, cool. Let's jump to the next one. Ah, a classic. Such a classic. So, we're having fun or a good time. Right? This is, of course, sort of idiomatic. But yeah, let's see what we got here. Vi er... I can't even say it. Nah, I gotta try. Vi er have sjov. Vi har det sjovt. Vi har en god tid. Vi er have en god tid. Okay, again. Vi er have sjov. Vi har det sjovt. Vi har en god tid. Vi er have en god tid. All right, now. A lot of learners are having problems here. It's very common. Which one is it? It is vi har det sjovt. That's the right one. Vi har det sjovt. Let's take them one by one. Vi er have sjovt. You might be thinking like in English or in Spanish or some other languages where you're saying like am doing, am having, or you are eating or sleeping. Is you get this from grund, eh? Yeah, but we don't have that in Danish the same way. And you don't say er, you don't say er before a verb like am doing or are doing, anything like that. No, I want to stress this because this is such a common mistake, especially if your English is very good. Then you're going to copy this into Danish, but that is wrong, okay? Don't do that. Just use the regular present tense. So, not have, not er have, but vi har, because it's present tense. So vi har det, vi har det sjovt. It's almost like an adverb, like we have it funny or we have it fun, right? Vi har det sjovt, because it's like I can say, jeg har det godt. Like, I'm good, I'm doing good, I'm feeling good. Where sjovt is fun or funny. So yeah, that is sort of the rule that you want to go by here. Vi har en god tid, the third one. Oh, what can I say? This is, of course, the very literal to have a good time. Right? But we don't say this. Yeah, you can probably find someone who said it, but that means like a good time period, like a good phase in their life. If you want to say you have fun, you don't say har en god tid, okay? Vi har det sjovt, that's the one. And the last one, vi er have en god tid. I basically combined these two previous mistakes, and we don't say it. Eh? We don't have any of this er have, like... am having is not in Danish, all right? As other languages. All right, just give me a sec. that's how it is. All right, moving on. All right, I want all of it. This should be interesting. Jeg have alt det. Jeg vil have alting af det. Jeg vil have alt af det. Jeg vil have det hele. Now, you can say have or hey. It's either way is fine. It's just in real life we tend to say hey. But if I say it slowly, then I kind of have to say have. So. Jeg have alt det. Jeg vil have alting af det. Jeg vil have alt af det. Jeg vil have det hele. Hey. Yeah, these look quite similar. Whoops. They look quite similar, so how can you tell? How can you tell the difference? Yeah, probably not what you think. The right one is... Jeg vil have det hele. Okay, let's break it down. So, the first one, jeg have alt det. It just makes no sense. Have is infinitive. You can't have infinitive right after the subject. It doesn't work like that. So yeah, that's wrong. Jeg vil have alting af det. Alting means everything, right? But it's not everything, it's all. So it's a little bit different. And also, you don't say a like this a if you a, that's not gonna work. Yeah. And the third one might look right. Jeg vil have alt af det. But here's the thing. In Danish, we don't say a when it's the totality or the entirety, when it's the whole thing. We don't say a, okay? Gonna repeat this. When you have the whole thing, you don't say a. You do say a when it's a part or a piece, a subset, right? For example, en af dem, one of them, eller flere af dem, several of them, mange af dem, etc. But not when it's the whole thing. So this is pretty big in Danish. It's a big difference when you compare it to English. It is, jeg vil have det hele. Yes, the fourth one. That's how it is. Because det hele means like all of it or the whole thing, right? And then you might think, oh, why not ting then if it's thing? Hey, it is what it is, right? Jeg vil have det hele. I want all of it. I want it all would be the same. So, I want it all. Not gonna say more of that. Let's move on. Can you feel the cold? Can you feel the cold? What we got? Kan du mærke kulden? Kan du mærke kold? Kan du mærke den kold? Kan du mærke kolde? Okay, alright. Kan du mærke kulden? Kan du mærke kold? Kan du mærke den kold? Kan du mærke kolde? Which one is it? Which one is correct? Yeah. Let's see. Kan du mærke kulden? The first one. Can du mærke kulden? Because kulde is the noun, right? And we're talking about cold, like coldness. Like the cold air or the concept of cold, not the adjective. So yeah, it's actually really simple. Kan du mærke kold? And that's just wrong, right? Because kold is the adjective. And the third one, kan du mærke den kold? Now I see a lot of learners, well, some learners who say den or de when they want to say the, and like the cold. But that is wrong. That is wrong unless you have like an adjective. Or something like den kold som, well, I'll get into that some other time. But generally speaking, when you want to say the in Danish, you just put the en or the et at the end. Don't think it's like English or Spanish or French or many other languages where you have to put it before. We put it at the end unless it's an adjective or some other circumstance that I won't comment on right now. Så kan du mærke den kold? No, hell no. Kan du mærke kolde? It doesn't even make sense. Mærke kolde, then I'd be like, kolde hvad? Like, what is a cold thing? Bananas, fingers, peanuts? We don't know, right? So, again, kan du mærke kulden? Ja, mærke kulden. Det kan jeg ikke. Let's go to the next one. And the bag is free. I love this like exclamation point. All right, so and the bag is free. Let's see what we got here. Og tasken fri. Og den tasken fri. Og ryggen gratis. Og tasken gratis. Again. Og tasken fri. Og den tasken fri. Og ryggen gratis. Og tasken gratis. Yeah. What we got here? What is the right one? Who knows? Who knows it? All right, let's see the answer. A. Okay, there you go. Tasken er gratis. Here's the thing. The first one, tasken er fri. Fri means free as in freedom, like liberty. Like, oh yeah, free, I'm free. But not money free. Yeah, gratis is the word. So remember that. Tasken er fri. No. Den tasken er fri. Obviously also wrong. And on top of that, you can say den tasken, and because tasken means the bag, so den, which typically means like it or that, it's just like what? No, you can't do that. So tasken. Røgen. Røgen er gratis. That's kind of funny if you have a weird sense of humor. Røgen means the back, but the back of your body. So that's also in English BACK, not BAG. Different kind of back. So røgen, the back of your spine is free. I don't know where you're doing your shopping, but yeah. Og tasken er gratis. That is, of course, the right one. Because tasken, the back, and gratis is free. All right? It's a very good word. I'm sure you know it. I mean, who does know the word for free? De gratis. Yeah. All right. Let's go to the next one. He's too smart to do that. He is too smart to do that. Han er for klog til at gøre det. Oh, sorry. I'm too fast here. Han er til klog til at gøre det. Han er for smart gør det. Han er for klog til at gøre det. Han er for smart til at gøre det. Han er til klog til at gøre det. Han er for smart gør det. Han er for klog til at gøre det. Han er for smart til at gøre det. All right, which one is correct? Thinky. Which one is it? Let's see. Han er for klog til at gøre det. The third one. And why is that? Well, the first one. Han er til klog. When you want to say too, like too much, too smart, too hard, whatever, too hard, too cold, you gotta say for, right? Not till, for. So till clo, out with that, and can't use it. And also, you would have an at, and you can say tilgøre. You have til at gøre. So that's another mistake. The second one, han er for smart, gør det. So the for is right. But then smart is a little bit different, and I talk about this sometimes with my students. It's that smart in Danish, like if you say the word smart, it's not intelligent or wise or smart like in English necessarily. It's more like clever and clever smart or convenient or handy, like something. Oh, this smart. Oh, that's clever. And that's convenient, like a smartphone. So yeah. That is something you want to be aware of. The standard word for smart in Danish is klog. That is your go-to word for smart. And of course, gør here is imperative, so hell no. And then the third one, han er for klog til at gøre det. Han er for klog. He is too smart til at gøre det. To do it. And the last one is just wrong. Han er for smart til at gøre det. It's, yeah, we're missing the at. And we don't say smart. We would say klog. Because he's like all wise. Okay. Next one. I feel like dancing. Yes, this of course. I feel like dancing, like I wanna dance. Let's see. Jeg føler at danse. Jeg føler som danser. Jeg vil danse. Jeg har lyst til at danse. Jeg føler at danse. Jeg føler som danse. Jeg vil danse. Jeg har lyst til at danse. Okay. Let's think about this one. I feel like dancing. Most of you probably know how to say feel in Danish. Yeah, but you might be surprised in this case. Jeg har lyst til at danse. The last one. Jeg har lyst til at danse. Here's why. Jeg føler at danse makes no sense. And we gotta remember that in English, I feel like and then doing something. It's not that you feel like you're dancing. It's because you want to do it. And so you have to remember the meaning behind it. So generally speaking, when something is idiomatic or slangy or advanced in your own language, sorry, in your own language, then you don't want to translate it directly into Danish. This is a general thing in language learning. And so you have to be aware, like, what is the meaning behind? So, jeg føler som dansen. And it might look right, because you're like, oh, like is some, and lige is some, like. But no, no, still not right. Still not right. And jeg ville danse could be right if the sentence was, I wanted to dance. Right? But ville is, of course, the past. I wanted to dance. Now it's, jeg har lyst til at danse, since jeg har lyst til is I feel like doing. You know, lust, like lust, but it doesn't sound that dirty in Danish. It's kind of like in Spanish, ik tengo ganas, or something like that. So yeah. Jeg har lyst til at, and I feel like doing, whatever it is. That is the way. That's how you do it. Okay, moving on. It's time to make a snowman. Well, it is December. Det er tid til at lave en snemand. Det er tid at lave en snemand. Det er tid at lave en snemand. Det er tid at lave en snemand. Oh, these are so similar. Alright, let's see. Det er tid til at lave en snemand. Det er tid at lave en snemand. Det er tid at lave en snemand. Det er tid at lave en snemand. I might actually have misread these two because they're so similar. But you can see the spelling. They are super similar, so take a second and think which one is correct. When you want to say it's time to do something, what's the right way? I see some of you guessing in the live chat. That's awesome. You can all participate. That'll be hyggeligt. Okay, the answer is yes, the first one. Because when you want to say it's time to do something, you gotta have till in there. And tid til. Oh, det er tid til at gøre det. Ikke? Det er blevet tid til det. It's time for that. Something like that. Tid til at lave en snemand. So it is the first one. Tid at lave en snemand. The second one, well, we got no till. And you have that problem with the other ones. And here you don't even have at in the third one, so that's really broken. And then the fourth one, det er tid is no, because snemand, no, snemand is one word. In general, in Danish, we have these compound words. In English, you tend to separate them or use a dash or hyphen or something. But in Danish, we connect them into long-ass compound words, just like the Germans. Det er tid til at lave en snemand. Of course it is. Moving on. He's stronger than you. Now, this is a weird sentence. I don't know if you're ever going to use this. But anyway. So. Han er stærkere som dig. Han er stærk end dig. Han er stærkere end dig. Han er stærkere end du. Han er stærkere som dig. Han er stærk end dig. Han er stærkere end dig. Han er stærkere end du. Which one is correct? Yeah, you have to think about adjectives. I don't know how you guys feel about that, because I didn't teach so much about it. Like, in the superlative, like more of something. Yeah, also a matter of prepositions, I guess. Let's see the answer. Han er stærkere end dig, the third one. Yep, because the first one. Han er stærkere som dig. No, som means like or as, and as. So that's not gonna work. I have seen some students, especially Greek students, I don't know why exactly, they tend to confuse some and n, but they're different. Some is you are similar, right? Or the same, like you. But en, E-N-D, is than, and stronger than you. So you gotta know the difference. The second one, well, that's not gonna work because stack just means strong, but it has to be stronger. And so stärkare, or just stärkare, the way we normally say it. So han är stärkare än dig, of course that's the one. The fourth one, han är stärkare än du, well, that's not gonna work because du is you as a subject, right? But it gotta be dig, so it's the object. Yeah, we don't want to mix those two up. It's important to know the difference. Yeah. Alright, moving on. Oh yeah, she's in love. She's in love. What we got here? I think most of you will get this wrong. I'm not trying to be mean, but I think you will. You should still try to guess though. Hun er i kærlighed. Hun er i elske. Hun er i forelskelse. Hun er forelsket. Yeah. Hun er i kærlighed. Hun er i elske. Hun er i forelskelse. Hun er forelsket. She's in love. How do you know? How do you know which one to pick? Well. Alright, I'll tell you. Okay, my computer doesn't want to give you the answer. Not all the way. There it is. Hun er forelsket. Right? That's the one. Let's see. Let's look at the other ones. Hun er i kærlighed. No. You don't want to say hun er i kærlighed because kærlighed is just love as a concept. Oh, kærlighed er vigtig, like something, love is important. Or kærlighed, then the love. So don't say that. Oops, hit the mic there. And i elske, you can't say that because elske is the verb for love. So that's not going to work either. Kærlighed is the concept, elske is the verb. And the third one, kind of interesting. Hun er i forelskelse. Now forelskelse, that is sort of the romance, or the infatuation, some might say, the feeling when you are in love. Yeah, so i forelskelse, but you cannot be i forelskelse, that is not a thing. Right? The fourth one is right, because hun er forelsket is, she's in love. You could say, jeg er forelsket, du er forelsket, hun er forelsket, whatever. Right? So that's the one you want to use here. Not kærlighed, not elske, not forelskelse, but forelsket, og forelsket. You want to be very dictionary about it. Yeah. And that is awesome. And that was the last one. Wow. Well. Then I want to say thank you for watching to everyone who's watching. And I really like when you're typing something in the live chat. That's always good. I like an active community. It's awesome. Now, of course, as always, I got to do these things a certain way. And one of those things. Is to say thank you, a special thanks to all the members of this channel. You got your names right here. And you yourself can also become a member by checking the links that I have in the description. You can get all the videos, basically. You also get some cool PDF files, and yeah, it's a way to learn more. So definitely consider that. There's a lot of videos that you don't get for free. Definitely worth it. But maybe you wanna, you know, you prefer going to the website instead. Right? So, DanishMastery.com. Right? DanishMastery.com, you get the videos for life. You get lifetime access. So that's the same videos. It's the same videos as in the membership, but you only pay once. Right? So you don't have to worry about, you know, some subscription or anything. No. You only pay once. It's pretty simple. And in there, you also got some other bonuses. I'll show you in a second here. Yeah, you see I got three packages here, right? Maybe you're a beginner and you just want to learn some basic stuff. That's cool. You know, I got the basic videos here. Yeah, so it's a good handful. A pretty big handful, 70 videos. You got the most videos, I think, so this will be good for probably most learners. Although it's not everything. It gets most videos. Got around 340 videos. All levels from very basic to advanced. It covers all levels. But it doesn't have everything because the biggest one, all videos deluxe, and you got all deluxe. You got 370 videos, and this one is always growing. So like all future videos, they go here. All, like there's nothing being held back. You also get some other cool bonuses. It's pretty awesome. You can see the difference here. The first one here being the basic package, or the basic video collection. And just basic phrases and verbs, adjectives, adverbs, beginner videos. And over here in the most videos, you got almost everything. Like you got the vast, vast majority of the videos. And so it's a whole lot of stuff. And then the final one, you also get all those videos plus new videos, right? Yeah, this one in the middle doesn't get the new videos. But here you get all the new videos in the last one. Plus some of these other bonuses that you can see. Like you can be in a WhatsApp group, you can ask me questions, you get some grammar exercises, PDFs and little short story chapters, little podcast episodes, and you get the ebook, the Ultimate Danish Phrasebook. So it's pretty sweet, if I may say so myself. Yeah. Alright guys, I think that's about it. Thank you so much for watching, and have a good day, alright? Let's enjoy this cold month of December. It is soon Christmas after all. Alright, gotta take off. Peace.